this video, I'll be unboxing the Ecobee3 smart Wi-Fi thermostat and then installing it inside my house without a C wire. After, I'll pair the Ecobee3 remote sensors with the Ecobee3 thermostat. Then I'll pair the Ecobee with Alexa using an Amazon Dot to show you how to send commands to Alexa. Later, I'll go over the Ecobee thermostat settings and show you how to adjust things like the comfort settings using the Ecobee app on the iPhone. And now let's get started with an unbox.
So this is the Ecobee3, the smarter Wi-Fi thermostat with room sensors for homes with more than one room. As indicated, it works with Apple HomeKit and includes a smart thermostat and three room sensors. I've not used the Apple HomeKit yet on my personal applications, but I have been using the Amazon Alexa for a lot of my smarter home things, and this also integrates with that. Looking at this side, just more marketing. On the back, we have some diagrams that show how on a multi-level home or a complicated install, you have the multiple room sensors for comfort reimagined. And so it just says that ordinary thermostats read the temperature in one room, which can make your favorite rooms uncomfortable. And as mentioned, the Ecobee3 has room sensors that will let you deliver the right temperature in rooms that matter the most. So what I'm really interested in is the ability to control it from anywhere. Here it says that you can adjust your Ecobee3 on your phone, tablet, or computer. It works with Apple Watch, iOS, and Android devices. So that's something I'm gonna probably set up in this video. It's supposed to work with my particular heat pump, which is two-stage. I think some people say it also works with variable speed. And that's about all the interesting things on the box. I'm gonna go ahead and open it up now. All right, so inside we have the Ecobee3 unit. Little tag here to download the Ecobee app to begin your installation. This looks like one of the sensors. Main unit itself. Comes with a nice little level there to make sure that it looks straight on your wall. Now this is pretty handy. They give you this power extender kit. Now this is for people that don't have a five-wire bundle going to their current thermostat. I wasn't sure if I had one. It looked like I only had the four, and I did not have the blue or common wire showing. But when I opened up the thermostat, it was in the bundle just tucked away. So hopefully that's the situation that you have. If not, then you can use this guy. And here's the additional three sensors. And it looks like they come with little stands as well. And over here, it seems like we have some mounting hardware. Yep. We have the anchors and screws. And that's what you get. Now that the Ecobee3 is unboxed, I'm going to replace my 7-day Honeywell with the new Ecobee.
So here we are in the hallway with the old thermostat. I've pulled this from the wall to show you the wires. It had its own existing wall anchors. I filled those in and painted at this point, just to save me some time later. So now my next step is going to be to remove the faceplate off the old unit and label the wires. So if you've decided you don't want to deal with the mess from the old thermostat, the Ecobee does come with this larger faceplate in the back of the box that'll kind of cover your hole. I want to go for a cleaner, smaller look, so I patched mine. In the back of the box behind that cover is going to be wire labels as well. And you're supposed to take these wire labels and wire your existing thermostat wires to help you with the next part of the installation. So we're going to do that now. My existing thermostat was not using the blue common wire. Fortunately though, in my case, in the wire bundle coming from the heat pump was the blue wire. It was just tucked away inside the wall. So before you install the power extender kit, see if maybe you already have that. So now I'm going to remove the faceplate from the Honeywell to expose the wires underneath. So now that the wiring block is exposed, I need to label these wires. Now before you go any further, you'll want to shut off power at the breakers. Okay, now that the power is off, I can remove the RC wire. I'm going to find the corresponding RC sticker from the sticker block that Ecobee included and put that on the wire. While the blue common wire is out, I might as well label that. Next, I'm going to move on to the OB wire, which in my case is white. The next one for me is my Y or yellow wire. And lastly, I'm going to disconnect the G or green. Helps when they match up. Okay, at this point, all the wires are disconnected. I've removed the old faceplate from the Honeywell thermostat. All right, now that we have our wires free, we can start by attaching the back plate. It comes with this little green cover we have to remove. And it comes with a nice little level there to help with our install to keep it nice and straight on the wall. So we're gonna sneak these wires through first. We can kind of center this where we want it now. And once you have it nice and level, you can use the eye holes here and mark a nice center point. And once you have that, we'll have to take this off and install some wall anchors. Okay, to attach the Ecobee mounting plate to the wall, you'll use the included drywall anchors that they provide and a 3/16 drill bit. And use your previously marked holes. I'm all trying to keep straight here. Make nice holes in the wall. As you can see, you can just push those drywall anchors in if you did everything correctly. Now that you have your anchors attached, you can slip the cover plate back over, or the mounting plate, whatever you want to call it. Feed the wires through, recenter it over there. Now you'll need a Phillips head screwdriver. And just screw that in there nicely. And if you don't pay close attention like I just did, you'll end up using the wrong screws. Apparently, I don't know what the other ones are for, probably the larger faceplate, but you'll want the ones with the fatter head on them. Just take those out and try again. Now, if you don't get it perfectly level, don't worry, only you'll know, and maybe some obnoxious relatives, and you can always ask them to leave your house. Now that you have the back plate mounted, you can go ahead and tuck your wires in a little bit and give yourself some space to work. Using the labels you made earlier, I'm gonna start with my C wire. As you push these in, the springs should catch the wire. And if you give them a gentle tug, they should not come out. I just hooked up the RC. Now we're gonna install the G. And now the yellow Y1. Now finally the OB. Now that all the wires are connected, let's attach the faceplate for the Ecobee3. Now let's remove the protective film. And we can turn on power at the breaker. So unfortunately, after I hooked up the faceplate, the unit did not turn on. The faceplate stayed dim, although it did run the fan. So that got me looking at the troubleshooting steps in the manual. And it turns out the C wire that I thought I had was not actually giving all the power that it needed. It was only giving about 9 volts instead of the required 24 volts that's supposed to be on the C wire. So at that point, I called Ecobee tech support and sent them pictures of my setup. They weren't actually quite sure what to make of my current wiring on my variable speed blower. They weren't sure if it was actually compatible at all. At that point, I made the decision to call my local air conditioning company and have them come out and check out my wiring. It turns out that my C-wire, or what I thought was my C-wire, was not being used for that purpose. When the air conditioning technician looked at my particular wiring setup, he decided it was best to go ahead and just put in a junction and wire up a dedicated C-wire without using the power extender kit. Once the C-wire was correctly connected, I reinstalled the faceplate and the Ecobee fired up after about a minute. It then goes into some calibration and asks you some questions and asks you to register. That part was really straightforward and easy to do. And at this point, the Ecobee has been working very well with my Trane air conditioner. So the version of the Ecobee I got from Costco comes with three of these included room sensors. Setting them up was really easy. They're gonna come with a non-conductive tape on the back to protect the battery and shipping. And all you do is take that off and hold it in front of the unit like this, and it will immediately ask you to go ahead and pair it and give it a name. This is really cool because when I set it up with the Alexa later in the video, you'll see that it will know the name of the sensor when you're asking Alexa questions. So if you ask what temperature is it in the bedroom, it will tell you. Alexa finds all the sensors as well as the Ecobee itself.
I can't find songs by Elvis Answers.
Now these room sensors are really handy and probably one of the features that separates the Ecobee from other products like the Nest, because a lot of people will have their thermostats in an area of the house that doesn't really get good representative temperature of what's going on inside, like a remote bedroom far away or something like that, or if you have a problem hot or cold spot in your house. You can put these sensors in there and the Ecobee will cool to that desired temperature. So from what I can tell, the Ecobee also leverages the motion sensor that's inside here and can tell if you're actually in that room, and it's not going to control the temperature if you're not in there, or it doesn't detect someone in there. So that's pretty handy, and it also uses it for coming on and off of the scheduled programming. So now let's take a closer look at the Ecobee 3 and some of the built-in features. Okay, so now we're taking a closer look at the face of the Ecobee. At the top, you can see a snowflake indicating it's currently in cooling mode. The Ecobee allows you to set it to either always cooling or always heating, or let it dynamically switch, which is something that the Honeywell I had before did not have the option to do. In addition, it will show you the current indoor humidity, which is something I didn't have before. Currently, that's indicated by this dewdrop showing 63%. And currently the indoor temperature at the thermostat is 76 degrees. And on the right, we have a slider that allows us to manually set the current temperature. So when I go and set that to 73 degrees, it's going to indicate here down at the bottom that it's currently at 73 degrees and holding because I'm doing an override. To cancel that, I just push on the X and it tells me that it's resuming the schedule. We go ahead and click the what I like to call the hamburger menu here on the left. It takes you into the various system settings. Currently the system's on cool. HVAC is set to cool, and I have the fan on auto. It's worth noting that you can actually cycle the fan for a certain amount of time per hour if you really want to. That's not recommended usually in Florida because it increases the indoor humidity, but maybe in other places you like to do that to keep the air moving throughout your house. And here you can see the sensors. Currently I have the smart home away disabled. I am using that follow me function, which to my understanding will try and see what room you're currently in and set the temperature based on that. So right now at the Ecobee, temperature is showing 74 degrees and it's occupied, and the master bedroom is currently unoccupied as well as the office. In my house, rooms like the office tend to get a little bit hotter due to the computers in there, so I figure that's a good place to put a remote sensor. You can also go in here and check the schedule. You can set that from here. I found it a little bit easier to control the scheduling from the webpage once you create your account. You can actually go in and set that up on ecobee.com. Looking at comfort settings. Now the Ecobee has three comfort settings, one for when you're home, one for when you're away, and one for when you're sleeping. If we go in, you can see what it can control here. Top we have your heat setting. On the bottom you have your cooling setting, with your fan controls. So you can have it set to on or auto. In Florida, where humidity can be an issue, auto is usually recommended. You can have it tell when you're home by enrolling certain sensors or all of your sensors. Currently, I have all my sensors participating, which is what's being indicated down there. And it just follows the same setup for away and sleep, so you can control what temperature you want it to be when you're not home and when you're sleeping as well. And lastly, this is how you set up your vacation mode. To save energy, the system won't be turning on when you're not there. You can also control that remotely from the app or their webpage. There's also an option for reminders. I haven't gotten into this too much myself, but it lets you set up things like when you should change your furnace filter, or if you have a UV lamp, or when certain temperature settings are breached. So, you know, if you're up north and your pipes might freeze because something's not working right, that's pretty handy. Or the high temp alert if you're in Florida like me and your air conditioning might be broken. It looks like you can restrict access to your Ecobee3 features by setting a security code. So I guess this is one way to win any heating or cooling arguments in your house, is whoever gets here first and sets the code. This middle button here will tell you the weather, in case you don't have a million apps that already do that. The Ecobee does actually use the weather data though to correlate your energy usage history when it generates the report on their website. And if you decide that you're just like outside of your schedule and you don't want to rely on sensors or anything, you can just do manual overrides for saying that you're home or away at any given time. You can set this also on your phone. All right, next let's set this up with Alexa. To enable the Ecobee skill with Alexa, search for the word Ecobee in the Alexa app on your iPhone or Android device. Select the Ecobee skill from the list and open it up. Now click on the Enable button. You'll need to enter your Ecobee username and password to sign in. Log in. Cancel that. And now scroll down, and you'll need to click on Accept here for the Alexa agreement. Next, click on Discover Devices, which will allow Alexa to go out, search for, and discover devices on your network. So here it's picked up some of my previously installed TP-Link smart switches, and it looks like it's also found my remote sensors for the Ecobee. I'm going to scroll down, click on My Ecobee down here, which will open up the thermostat and show me the temperature controls, which I can change by pushing on these buttons, but we'll close out of here now.
Now that we've paired Alexa with the Ecobee, we can start sending it commands. Alexa, what temperature is it in my office?
The office temperature is 74 degrees.
Alexa, what temperature is it in the master bedroom?
The master bedroom temperature is 73 degrees.
Alexa, set the temperature to 75 degrees.
The AC is set to 75.
Thank you.
No worries.
Now we're taking a look at the Ecobee app itself. It's very similar to the faceplate of the Ecobee unit. And again, you can just go ahead and scroll up and down to change the temperature as you'd like. And when you select the temperature, it's going to go ahead and indicate the holding pattern if you're doing a manual override. If you cancel out, it tells you you're resuming. And has all the same settings that we just went over on the faceplate itself with regard to showing you the weather and all the various settings on your Ecobee. I do have to say that the app itself feels a little bit sluggish, and I am not 100% certain, but it does appear to use a lot of battery.
I've been really impressed with the Ecobee3 now that I got past the issues with the common wire during the Ecobee installation. I would recommend buying a package that includes remote sensors or picking up some additional ones, because really that's the strongest feature I feel that it has over the Nest. Time will tell if the cost savings made it worth its initial upfront price, but other features like the Amazon Alexa integration and then just the convenience there really make up for it. So I hope you found the review helpful. Please let me know by leaving a comment below or clicking on the like button, and thanks for watching.